Good afternoon to every one of you. Today we are going to discuss about the last topic of third unit, which is command line arguments. Right. So in the previous video we have seen file inclusion and conditional compilation, and this is the last topic of third unit, which is command line arguments. This is very simple topic. So this is the mandatory feature to be known in case of a C programming language, right? Let's get into the topic. Command line arguments, as the name implies. So command line arguments are nothing but we are giving the arguments. We generally pass our arguments to the function through the function for processing, right? So the arguments are nothing but for processing of values, we pass values from either through address or else through value from one place to another place, either to from main function to sub function or else sub function to main function. So this is how that is regularly we do with programming. In case of command line arguments, we pass the arguments to the main function at the runtime, right? So we pass, that is what it is called, command line arguments. So we pass the arguments to the main function when the program is getting executed at the runtime, right? So that is the major feature of command line arguments. The main function is the most significant function of C and C++ languages. The main function typically defined having a return type of integer and having no parameters, something like. So we generally do with, we don't pass any arguments to the main function, right? Because we always have main function doesn't accept any argument, something like int main body of the function and so on. So here command line arguments provides the facility to pass the arguments to the main function, right? So let's see a simple example of syntax. So int main, so as the function, as the sub function of we write sub functions for our program, right? So there will be a name and there will be a return type and there will be an argument list, right? Here main function also accepts some arguments, right? That is called command line argument. So we pass this argument when the program is getting executed, right? We'll see the example. So look at the syntax here. Main function is returning as an integer type and it accepts two arguments. The important thing you want to note down in case of command line argument is the first argument, these two arguments. Look at, you cannot, there is no necessity that you should use the same name, that AGRC and AGRV, right? The first argument is nothing but number of arguments. It is of integer type, right? Please make note of it. The first argument of main function is nothing but the number of arguments passed, which is of integer type, number of arguments, right? Please remember. And the second argument is nothing but a character pointer array, right? And it consists of the values of the arguments, purely depends on the previous parameter, previous argument. Here we are defining number of arguments, whereas here we are supplying the values of the arguments, right? Please make a note of these two arguments. These two are very important things in case of command line arguments. The first argument is nothing but arguments, number of arguments count, which is of integer type, whereas the second argument is nothing but the pointer array, it's of character type and it consists of the values of the arguments, right? So whatever, even if it is of pi, if you are passing an integer value into the second argument, it takes it as a character type, right? So if you are going to process it as an integer value, then you want to type convert it, right? Type convert in the sense from character to integer, integer type, right? So we'll discuss it later. So please, this is the major syntax of command line argument is. So no need to, it can be of void type also. So this is completely out of this topic. And main function accepts two arguments, AGRC. You can have any name also for this argument. You can have AB also. So there is no problem with using the name of the argument. So here the general type is AGRC, which is nothing but argument count. And the second one is nothing but the pointer array, which consists of the values of the arguments, which is of character type, right? So look at the important thing you want to note down in the second argument is nothing but it's a character array. As I already said, it is a character array. right? And this character array, in this character array, the first and foremost argument in the character array holds the value of the name of the file program, right? Name of the program name, right? Name of the program, right? So that is what the first and foremost argument is. And the rest of the arguments from 1 to n is nothing but the value of the arguments, right? So the first argument alone, right, is holding the file name, and the rest of the arguments are holding the value of the argument, right? So this has to be remembered, right? So please remember, the first argument is nothing but number of arguments we are going to pass, and the second argument is nothing but it's a character pointer array which consists of the values of the arguments. And in that second argument, the first argument is the first index value, first location of the character array pointing to the file name of the program, right? And rest of the things holding the value of the argument. Let's see an example so that you can have a better understanding compared to your theoretical explanation. Look at, so here I have executed, I have three examples to be shown to you, and the first and foremost example is, look, so very simple example. So stdio.h, and it's of integer type. This return type may be of anything. So now I am using an integer type, so it has to return 0, right? So okay, as I already said, it accepts two arguments, so it has to be given like this. So int main, so far whatever the programs we have done, so we didn't pass any of the arguments to the main function. Here we are passing two arguments, which is int agrc. You can use, as I said, you can use any name for this arguments, right? So int agrc comma character of argv, and it's of character type, right? It's a character pointer array, right? Fine. So in the main function, I am writing two print statements. One is nothing but argument count percentage d, I am printing argc, and in the second printf statement, I am printing the file name. As I already said, this second argument holds the values of the argument along with the first index value, holds the file name. I am just printing the file name alone, right? So argv of 0, right? The first memory location of the character pointer array pointing to the file name of the program, right? So I am just printing the file name alone, which is agrb of 0, and I am just getch and return 0. Why I am using Turbo C instead of Dev C++ is because in the previous videos I have explained the concepts through Dev C++. In this command line argument, I am using Turbo C because you people are using Turbo C. Here the execution is somewhat different compared to a normal program in C programming. So that's why I have used Turbo C, so that you feel comfortable when you are executing your programs in the home, right? So the things you want to do, because it's of entirely different concept, first you want to compile it. So compiling, no errors, 0. And before that, you just want to go to arguments. There is a option called in the run option. Look at, in the run option, you have arguments as a list. So in that, you can give any number of arguments, right? Let's take, I'm giving 5 arguments, right? So with separated with space, right? A single space. Now you have defined the arguments. 5 arguments has been passed. Now run it. First you want to compile it, no error. Next one, execute the program. So look at, just before that, clear screen, because it is displaying the previous output also. CLR SCR of 5. Now trying to compile it again. Yes, no error. Run. Yes. What does it print? The argument count is, it shows the argument count is 6, and it prints the file name, right? So look at the program. Please remember that output. So I'm asking the program to print the argument count. So look at the arguments I have given is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It supplies 5 arguments. What does it print? It prints number of arguments as 6. Why it is? Because it takes the file name as one of the argument, right? So file name also as in one of the argument, right? So file name as one of the argument and list of values, rest of the values. So 5 plus 1, 6 number of arguments are taken, right? And it prints the file name. You can see the output again, right? Look at argument count is 6 and program name, right? It takes program name as one of the argument and also with rest of the arguments, right? I have passed 5 values along with the program name. It takes 6 number of arguments, right? Because file name is also another argument. Look at AGRC. AGRC is nothing but number of arguments passed, and here file name is the first argument and rest of the values are rest of the arguments. So total 6 number of arguments are calculated, right? Printed. So that is what the first program is. Let's see one more simple program so that you can have a clarity, more clarity on command line argument is. Okay. The second program is just I'm printing all the argument values, right? Nothing more. So the similar AGRC, it accepts 2 arguments. You can have a different name also, as you already said. AGRC is the first argument. Now it is having the value of number of arguments passed. And second is nothing but the value of arguments along with the file name, right? I'm using an integer variable I, and it's a clear screen, and I'm printing just number of arguments and program name I'm printing, which is AGRB of 0. As you already said, the first value in the character array is holding the file name, right? So I'm printing AGRB of 0, and from there I'm running a for loop until AGRC, because AGRC is holding the number of arguments passed, right? If I am passing 5 number of arguments, it runs for 5 values, right? So AGRC, I am running up to AGRC, 0 to AGRC, which is strictly less than, and printf arguments %d. %d is nothing but I am printing the value of I, and is %s. So why I am giving %s? It's nothing but a character array, right? Because this is a character pointer array, that's why I have given %s, right? So %s, I am printing AGRB of I, right? Each time it prints the respective user given argument value, right? So that is what it is getting printed. Let's execute this program. So look at the same arguments list is stored 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So no doubt about it. So you can first compile your program, no errors, and you can run your program. So it shares some warning. You want to return certain value since because of integer return type, return 0. I'm trying to save the file, compile the program, no errors, run the program. Yes, look at the output. So it gives argument count as 6, as I already said, list of arguments is 5, along with the file name, it takes it as 6. And the program name is, look at, it prints the program name, and argument 0, look at the important thing in this output. Argument 0 is nothing but the file name, argument 1 is nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So please remember, as I already said, the first and foremost argument in the second parameter is nothing but the file name, and rest of the things are integer values, values supplied by the user, right? So that is what printed here. You can have a revisit of your output also. 6 is nothing but total number of arguments, and it is printing all the 6 arguments. The first argument is nothing but the file name. Rest of the arguments are values supplied by the user. So let's see one more simple program so that you can have a better understanding. Okay, nothing more. So I'm just making a sum of all the arguments passed to the main function, and I'm calculating the sum, and I'm printing the sum, nothing more. So this is what the final program of command line arguments. So hope you are good visible compared to the previous program. So it accepts 2 arguments, AGRC, and AGRV. It's a character pointer array, and I'm using two variables. One is integer, another one is sum. And first I'm printing the argument count, and second I'm printing the file name, which is AGRV of 0, right? And I'm printing all the arguments, right? Look at this as like the similar program, previous program. I equal to 0, I less than AGRV of C, I plus plus, print of arguments are, I'm just printing all the arguments, nothing more. So in the percentage D, it prints the value of I, and in the percentage S, it prints the respective arguments list supplied by the user. And in the next print statement, sum of arguments are, so I'm calculating the sum, right? The important thing you want to note down is the list, this loop will run up to AG or C. Right, which is nothing but total number of arguments passed, right? And I am declaring a value which is assigned to 0. So sum equal to sum plus, this is a important function. This converts a character value into integer value, a to I, right? So that is called a function, a to i. This is a function that converts a character value into an integer value. As I said, this second argument is a character pointer array, so we cannot able to sum a character value into, and we cannot able to perform an addition operation between a sum value, sum is an integer value, and this argument list are character values. So we cannot make an addition in this, in between a character value and an integer value. So we need to convert this character value into an integer value, right? So using this ATOA function, I am converting this argument, every arguments in the AGRV second parameter into one integer value, right, through this function ATOI, right? So once it is converted, it can be added to the sum value, and all the arguments that is passed to this, all the arguments that are passed to the main function is getting summed, and the final value is calculated in the sum, and finally I am printing the sum value. So let's compile this program. Before that, you check for arguments list, so you can have more number of arguments. I am supplying 10 arguments to this program, right? And I am trying to compile. Yes, no error. And I am trying to run the program. Look at the total number of arguments is 11. So 10 number of values I have supplied. Along with that, it takes file name as one more argument. So it has taken 11 arguments, right? And file name is, this is what the file name. In the file name, so it prints along with the complete part, right? So exe file along with the complete part. Argument 0 is nothing but the complete path file name, and it takes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 until 10, and the sum of arguments is 55. If you calculate the sum from 10 to 1, so the total value is going to be 55, right? So this is how command line arguments are used in the C programming language. Right, so it is very important concept to be known in case of a C programming language, because industries, those who are working at runtimes, because in case of industry projects, people will not execute in terms of compile time programs. So they mostly perform runtime programs. So in runtime, this is command line argument is purely at runtime. The values and arguments are passed only at the runtime. So this concept will be very helpful in case of people who are supplying the values to at the runtime, right? So thank you. Next topic will be discussed in the next video. Thank you so much.